Good morning.
Morning.
Welcome to the Unitarian Oops, wait a minute. I didn't turn myself on. Okay. Is that better? Well, can you hear me? Okay. Welcome to the Unitarian Universalist Congregation of the Catskills. I'm Cheryl Chandler, the worship associate for this morning. Many thanks to our technical team for their help with this morning's service. A big welcome to everyone, whether you are attending live in the sanctuary or via Zoom. Unitarian Universalism is a liberal religious faith that carries no creed and welcomes all seekers. Whoever you are, whomever you love, wherever you are on life's journey, you are welcome here. We are guided by the values of justice, equality, transformation, pluralism, interdependence, and generosity, centered always in the power of love. We draw on many sources of wisdom and inspiration as we seek to understand the world, the universe, and mystery beyond all human knowing. We affirm that Black Lives Matter. We are a welcoming and affirming congregation for the LGBTQ community. We are a congregational affiliate of the Ulster Immigrant Defense Network, and we're an active voice in the effort to address climate change. Our sanctuary is built on the land of the Lenni Lenape people. You can visit our website, uucatskills.org, to find contact information, to be added to the mailing list, and to find the latest newsletter. You will also find newsworthy items on upcoming events in our UU community. Please take a moment to greet those seated around you. A special welcome to all our visitors with us today. If you are in person in the sanctuary and would like to introduce yourself, please raise your hand as we'd love to say hello and welcome you personally. Anyone here?
No? It's my second time here. I'm Kate. I just moved here from Ohio.
Welcome. If you're a visitor online and would like to be added to our mailing list, you can put your name and email address in the chat box area. After the service, please stay for an in-person or virtual coffee break. A reminder, please take a moment to turn off your cell phones or other electronic devices. Give yourself permission to be fully present here and now. We have a few announcements. First announcement, is there books there? If there are any that interest you, please feel free to take them home. And we have a message from Kathy DiMattadio. Coffee hosts are needed for October, November, and beyond. It isn't hard, and it's much appreciated. And Kathy, just see Kathy, okay? And Carol has an announcement.
Good morning.
Morning.
Every 2 years, the Committee on Shared Ministry, of which I'm a member, is asked and tasked to assess the status of our congregation. This is especially important now with the arrival of our new minister, our sale of the property, and our transition elsewhere. You should have received an announcement regarding this survey in your email. And if not, there are hard copies outside on the welcome table. They look like this. Or look for the link of the survey in the weekly update. The survey should be completed by you all, and we hope you'll do that for us, and submitted by October 20th at the service. And thank you for participating in this.
Thanks, Carol. And Coco has an announcement.
Good
Good morning. I'm Coco Wilde, and for at least the next few weeks, I am the presenter for First Acoustics, the concert series that has been putting on shows here. As some of you may know, the next two First Acoustics concerts will be our last. We are celebrating 16 years of music here and in Brooklyn with two outstanding artists. On October 13th, our penultimate concert, I love saying that word, even though I don't like the reason that I'm saying it. Trett Fury will be with us, and with special guest Lisa Klotz, who is a local artist who has just produced a new CD that is wonderful. Trett Fury will be here. Trett is a legend in the world of women's music, giving voice to all who believe and live the truth that love is love. She is a tireless advocate for workers' rights, particularly those of independent musicians. And she does all of this while she is stirring our hearts with her poignant and quite often funny observations about personal relationships. And then on November 3rd, with a lump in my throat and maybe a tear in my eye, we will welcome Joe Crookston to sing us home. If you are not familiar with Joe Crookston, I urge you to go to his website or check him out on YouTube. His musicianship sometimes feels magical. This is Joe Crookston right here. And his songwriting will just take you through a complete range of emotions, sometimes in one song. Bruce and I saw him at a festival yesterday, and I went over to him and I said, Joe, I'm sad that First Acoustics is ending, but I am honored that you are going to be the person who will be with us for our farewell concert. If you're interested in either of those shows, I invite you to see me after the service. You can make a reservation and pay at the door, or you can take care of all of it now. Those of you who are Zoomers, we do offer our concerts as a live stream. So there are so many ways to be with us and celebrate this turning point in Bruce and my life and in the life of our concert series. I hope you'll be with us. Thank you.
Thank you, Coco. Our prelude this morning just turned 70. These are required. Okay. The prelude this morning is The More I See You by Mack Gordon and Harry Warren, played by Catherine Cattabiani.
Thank you.
Thank you, Catherine. Please, the children. Children, come up to light the chalice. Children? Any children want to come? If you can fit in here so we can all see you. Just pass it along. Come light the big candle. Come with me. Okay, do this. I'm gonna take it. I'm gonna tip it down. You did it. Wow. Good for you. Wanna blow that? Please join me in saying the words for lighting the chalice in your order of service. May we be reminded here of our highest aspirations and inspired to bring our gifts of love to all living beings. May we know once again that we are not isolated, but connected in wonder, joy to the universe, in this community, and each other. And I just got it wrong, so now, the chalice lighting words. We light this chalice in grateful, loving community. Even in the darkest of times, may its flame light paths to courage, justice, and hope. Opening words. Strength is the ability to overcome, prevail, and endure. Emotional or inner strength is the bedrock that carries us through life's trials and triumphs, empowering us to rise above adversity and find resilience within. At its core, it's an attitude that enables you to manage life's difficulties with grace and steadfastness. It's the ability to withstand criticism, disapproval, and judgment, while staying true to your values and beliefs. It is having the courage to stand alone, to make tough decisions, and take full responsibility for the outcomes. Strength is a powerful word for a powerful feeling. It is the ability to rise above what life throws at you. It's allowing yourself to feel the darkness of the world while never losing sight of the wonder that surrounds you every day. Strength is finding humor in the worst moments of your life and still seeing the possibilities ahead of you. It's taking the time to learn and educate yourself and others. Being mentally strong isn't about holding in your emotions. It is instead about learning how to grow from them, learning how to make them work for you instead of against you. Life is unpredictable. When life throws curveballs, inner strength offers the perseverance required to navigate through. It enables us to bounce back from failure, keep going against all odds, and hold our heads high. Life's challenges are opportunities. Strength cannot be cultivated without challenges. Inner strength is a deep belief in yourself that gives you peace, a sense of calmness and meaning that enables you to keep going through the tough times. Inner strength is the unwavering power within you that fuels your determination to achieve success. It's the essence of our character and integrity, enabling us to make wise decisions, contribute to others, and maintain our well-being despite adversity. Strength is steady and strong like tempered steel. There's a reason temperament is used when talking about someone's personality, as well as the process of making steel. It's because someone who is strong has been tempered. They've been broken and built themselves back up. They've been in the fire, and they have survived the hammering of life. They have done this until unbreakable. Tempering, while unpleasant, makes us wise, empathetic, and strong. It is essential to being a well-rounded human. Nothing will break a truly strong person because they have learned how to bend and they will rise above whatever gets in their way. This is not to say that they will not feel like they are breaking. They will. It's to say that they will fight back. You never know how strong someone truly is until you see them under pressure. That is when you get to see the flash in their eyes, like a well-crafted blade, glinting off whatever is in their way. Everyone has the potential to handle more than they may even know. That's the beauty of hidden strength. And that strength is fundamental to a happy, fulfilling, and productive life. Your song next. Yes, okay.
And speaking of strength, this song is all about America. It was, just to put it in context, this was written in 1947. And 2 years later, Frank Sinatra made a film of the song. It was a very controversial song at the time, and leave it to Frank Sinatra for making it less controversial by taking away the part that talked about black and white. What is America to me? A name, a map, the flag I see, a certain word, democracy. What is America to me? The house I live in, a dream that must come true, a land of wealth and beauty, and there's work for all to do. The right to earn a living, to make us really free, where everyone is working, that's America to me. The house I live in, the same for black and white, my country if it's wrong, the chance to set it right. A land where all are equal, the house I want to see, where all will have four freedoms, that's America to me. The loved ones we remember. This is harder than I thought. Who fought that we might live. The nameless unsung heroes who gave all that one could give. Defenders of our freedom, the women and the men who love the house we live in but who won't come home again. The house I live in, my whole community, inclusive of all sorts of people who mean the world to me. Respecting one another, that's the only way to be. And the right to speak our minds out, that's America to me. The house I live in, to cherish and to love, to make a worthy dwelling in the image they dreamed of, a welcome on the doorstep for everyone to see, and a window to the future, that's America to me. The house we live in, where voting is the key, that opens up the doorway to our democracy. A vote for every citizen, that's the way it's got to be. Where everyone is voting, that's America to me. And a window to the future, that's America to me.
Thank you, Jeff.
Not for children only. A strong person may feel like they're incapable of something, but they'll try their best anyway. They go for things head on and with caution casing at their heels. Someone with true strength may not look strong, but you'll see it in their eyes. The beauty of inner strength is that it hides in such an obvious place. The eyes. Eyes express confidence, charisma, authority, and self-assuredness. After all, the eyes are the windows to the soul. In this, my favorite video of all time, I invite you to look into the eyes of the people you see and see if you can see the strength.
It's in every one of us to be wise. Find your heart, open up both your eyes. We can that I bought this ticket.
you see the strength? Sing our children now. Now time for the Now time for the offering. Through our half plate donations, we contribute to 8 local organizations who are living our values in the work they do, and the donations will be divided equally amongst them. You can donate with the baskets coming around or on our website with PayPal or by mailing your check through the US mail. You'll see a QR code on the order of service. Our offertory song is Love Is Here to Stay by George and Ira Gershwin, played by Catherine Cattabiani. Thank you, Catherine, and thank you for your generosity. I forgot one part of my opening words, and they were 5 quotes I gathered from famous people about strength, and I just wanted to share them with you. They were supposed to be at the beginning of the service. By Friedrich Nietzsche, that which does not kill us, makes us stronger. You've probably heard that. From Rosa Parks, you must never be fearful about what you're doing when it's right. From Hermann Hesse, some of us think holding on makes us strong, but sometimes it is letting go. Bob Marley,
You never know how strong you are until being strong is your only choice. And Christopher Reeve, a hero is an ordinary individual who finds strength to persevere and endure in spite of overwhelming obstacles. And now, Judith Chase will speak to us about strength.
Jeff, thank you for that wonderful song. I remember being about 10 years old and walking out of a Saturday movie program, on Union Turnpike in Queens, humming it and singing as many of the words as I remembered, and it's still with me, and you gave me a wonderful memory, so thank you for that. Cheryl, I am short, you're right about that, and old. The phrase inner strength doesn't appear in the 2,000 plus pages of my American Dictionary of the English Language, third edition, 1992. However, if we consider what is inferred by this phrase, inner strength, there's an intensity of learning and a holding on to a truth that you've discovered through pain, perhaps, or pleasure, or just meeting a new person. When we're able to clearly and honestly share what we've come to know, that makes us strong. It can take a while, a long while, and it might change over time, depending on new experiences, new friends, or study. To be honest, a big challenge for me is to give expressions of others room in the conversation. I'm trying to hear others better, the better to learn and share community with people I like.
Thank you, Judith. And now some words from L.J. McCaw about strength.
Hello, everyone. I'm LJ. I use he, they pronouns. So here we go. When I sat down to write this, my mind turned to my mother. It's cliche, really. My mom, who's dying of cancer, is the strongest person I know. It's the sort of thing that you put in a scene from a movie. The audience wipes tears from their eyes and then goes about their day experiencing a profound sense of catharsis. Well, let me tell you, there's nothing cathartic about living it. My mother is one of the strongest people I know. She's had constantly disabling migraines since I was a child. And through that, she managed to raise two kids and make sure we had everything we needed, if not quite everything we wanted. And now she has cancer. My mother is so strong, but here's the thing. I wish she didn't have to be. Far too often, we valorize people who've gone through hardships. We commend their strength. And that's okay, but I look at the people around me and I see so much strength. I'm proud to know such strong people, but I also want to say I'm sorry. I'm sorry that the world failed you. I'm sorry that you had to be strong. Maybe one day we'll build a world where we can all be weak as kittens and still survive. I raised one once, a kitten. My mom heard her crying outside the window and had to help. And as soon as I found out, I had to help too. Humans are good at helping when it comes down to it. Some animals give birth to young already able to walk or even lay and abandon eggs with the expectation that their children will manage on their own. Human babies only know how to do one thing, to cry. The very first thing each one of us does in our lives is ask for help. And we've not only survived as a species, but thrived. That kitten I raised is now a strong and sassy cat who wakes me up every morning to demand a walk. She trusts me to feed her and keep her safe. In return, she cuddles with me and keeps me from giving in to despair. It's a lot harder to give up on the world when there's a purring cat cuddled on your chest. And maybe that's a form of strength, too. It's not just one person bravely managing to soldier on in the face of misery. It's in communities, in building spaces where our strengths can bolster each other. Even when we can't communicate with each other in words, we can be strong alone. But it's so much easier to be strong in a community where we can lean on each other or even take breaks entirely and trust that others will pick up the slack. I don't know if this is coherent. I started writing this speech tired and angry and fed up with the whole concept of strength, but I seem to have talked myself back around. Despite everything, I'm an optimist. How can I not be? My mom has cancer, and it sucks. I hate that she has to be strong. I hate that my father has to gather his own strength to look after her. I hate that my sister and I have to find the strength to go through day-to-day life with this cloud hanging over us. But I've also seen just how many people have reached out, how many people have said, let me help you with that burden. And that's a strength that I can get behind.
Thank you, LJ. That was beautiful. Our hymn is in your teal book, 1021, and we are going to add a chorus after the last verse. Please join me in spirit or stand if you can, or in spirit. Lean on me. 1021.
We are.
Closing words. You have within you, right now, everything you need to deal with whatever the world can throw at you. Embrace your inner strength and resilience. Life's challenges are opportunities in disguise, and your ability to overcome them will define your success and character. And I'm going to end with 17 words that will never fail you. Strength. That's just the title. Here are the 17 words. And if these resonate with you, I put these in a basket there. You can hang them on your refrigerator to remind yourself every day to be strong. Prepare. Care. Believe. Forgive. Change. Risk. Listen. Choose. Relax. Pray. Persist. Smile. Focus. Act. Trust. Accept. And wait. Please join me in the words for extinguishing the flame in your order of service.
Extinguish this flame, but not the light of truth, the warmth of community, or the fire of commitment. These we carry in our hearts until we are together again.
From you I receive, to you I give, together we share.
Peace and with strength. Thank you.